Thus said the Lord. And as the officers have said before, we wish everybody a happy 4th of July.
Thank you, Doc.
And Independence Day. This was signed years ago, so we do honor that through our prayers and our thanksgiving to this great country that we live in. God has led me to this portion of scripture for many reasons. Because sometimes, as a minister of the gospel, with so much hate and sin in the world, it's hard to follow God's commandment when it says, love thy neighbor as you love yourself. There are so many evil and hateful neighbors in the world. But God has commanded us that we must love them anyway. Only way we can do that, not through self, because we have a sinful nature, but through the help of the Holy Spirit. We make a statement often, God can do anything but fail. And that is so true. But let us never forget that God has everything under His control. If it was not, we would be in much trouble. We have much to look forward to because God has not decided the end will be right now. Many other signs have to appear before the coming of the Lord. Many have already appeared, but much more must come. So God has given us all time to get our house in order.
Yes, He has. Yes, He has.
As the preacher prayed, if you have family members, try to get them into the house of God.
That's right.
Don't force them. You can't force them. Don't beg them.
Amen.
Just let them know that there's joy in the house of God.
Yes, it is.
There's peace in the house of God.
Yes,
there's love in the house of God. There's long suffering in the house of God. There's gentleness in the house of God. Yeah, there's forgiveness in the house of God. Above all, there's love in the house of God. So what a better place to be other than the house of God. Now what's His name?
Jesus!
God bless you. We need to keep our name in our vocabulary all the time. Well, that's why the power is. There's no power without the power of the Holy Spirit. In the 6th chapter of the book of Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, it speaks of being holy. You have to be holy. God is holy, and He expects for us to be holy. Not holier than thou, but just be holy. Because I'm going to read again. King James Version, the 6th chapter, beginning of the 14th verse. And listen to what it says here. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness? And what concord hath Christ with Baal? Or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel? And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, said the Lord Almighty.
Hallelujah.
What we're going to be speaking of this morning is be ye separated. Be ye separate. The church today is more worldly than any time in life.
Hallelujah.
In other words, the church has no saving power. We're just like the world. But what we need today is more pew evangelism. Just because a person comes to church and shouts, sing, does not mean they're saved. So we must evangelize those that we come in contact with, even in the house of God. Because we are his sons and his daughters. And I know sometimes I should not say this, but because I do not want to sound like I'm beating upon the church. But I must say what God tells me to say. And today, too many of us, I'm talking about pastors and churches, are compromising to please people instead of standing on the Word of God. We are compromising everything. But God said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. But we are calling sin today everything but sin. Afraid we might upset somebody. This is why God speaks to us through the local word, to upset us and to turn us from our wicked ways.
Hallelujah.
The church is the healing station in the world today.
Yes.
Although we all have a sin nature.
Yes, we do.
Don't think you are without sin.
Right.
Because even you look through sin, you and your five, what you call every God give you, eyes, your feeling, your smelling, your touching.
Yeah,
yeah. And you use them daily.
Amen. Yes, we do.
And that is just as sinful as you can get, because you're going to see things you shouldn't see.
Yeah, yeah.
Speak things you shouldn't speak.
Yeah.
Touch things you shouldn't touch.
Yeah.
And hear things you should not hear. But the church is a healing station. And we all are sick and in need of a doctor. But I got good news for you. That doctor is Dr. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, he will heal our sin-sick souls. Help me, Holy Ghost. We just came through a week of celebrating the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What a week that was. But we cannot stand and live on the past. We have to think of today and the future. That's why this is a day when the emphasis of our society is placed on strength by unity.
Yes. That's right. That's right.
We hear that we're going to make this country great again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to try to do it with all the money we have accumulated. But this account for many of your large corporation is dependent upon how much money they have. But in religious circles, there is a much said about the ecumenical movement. This is an effort to bring all Christian organizations into one vast movement. It's called the worldwide movement. But is there not a place yet for the conviction that there is a cause for separating and perhaps sometimes standing alone? We must stand alone if it means stand alone. We cannot compromise what God has put in the plan. God demands a separate people. The people of God are referred to as a chosen generation. We are a holy priesthood. We are a holy nation and a peculiar people. How do we come peculiar? Because we're leaving praising God and giving him the glory.
Yeah. Yeah.
If the world come into some churches and see you running around and shouting, they call you some kind of a nut.
Yeah.
Well, we are a nut for the holy power of God. Happy Holy Ghost.
You're doing all right,
God. Yeah, yeah. I don't know about you, but in time past, we were not a people. But God felt sorry for our souls. So that's why in 2 Chronicles 2, 9 through 10, we should show forth the praise who has called us out of darkness into that marvelous light. Which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which have not obtained mercy, but now have mercy. Lord God, has been good to us.
Yeah.
I could stand here and preach all day, but unless you know who he is, you cannot praise him and give him the glory.
Yeah.
The word of God, everybody that says, Lord, Lord, do not know me.
Yeah.
Oh, they know my name, but they do not know who I am.
Yeah.
But Jesus is the light of the world. Yeah, he's light and darkness. He's joy in the time of sadness. We're talking about Jesus. But the people of God are often referred to as strangers and pilgrims. This is not our home. We have a better home. We have a better place not made by God. Because we read in John the 14th one, said, let not your heart be troubled. He said, if you believe in God, believe also in me. He said, for in my Father's house, there are many mansions. There are no pump tents in my Father's house. All my houses in Father's house were made by God. You can call them tabernacle, you can call them temple, but the place is there. He said, I've gone to prepare a place for you. But he also promised he's coming back again. And who is he coming back for? He's coming back for a prepared person.
Yeah.
How do I prepare myself? By making sure I'm living according to God's plan.
Yeah.
Any plan other than God's plan is a sinful plan.
Yeah.
And my word tells that there be no sinners in hell, in heaven rather. All the sinners will be in hell. 2 Corinthians 6, 14, 18, you need to read it sometime. But this text let us know that there's more to come to church on a Sunday morning.
Yes.
There are things that we must do in order to lift up the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And this does not mean though that we become monks and hide ourselves from the outside world. Because we are the light of the world.
Yes.
We are the salt of the earth. And God has called us to let our little light shine.
Yes.
Where we are. You cannot let your light shine if you have a sunny lamp globe.
Right.
How did the lamp globe get soggy? Sunny? By doing things you should not do.
Right.
I have a trouble sometimes that we always find in fault with somebody else.
Yeah.
When you are your own worst fault.
That's right.
You, when you look in the mirror in the morning, you look at your worst enemy.
Yeah.
God, help me, Holy Ghost. The devil cannot make you do that one thing as a child of God. He lost that dominion over your life when Christ died on Calvary.
Yes.
He took that dominion back for you and I.
Yes.
So somebody better wake up now and know that you have power.
Yes.
Over all the evil folks of this world.
Amen.
But the word said, "Be not to be unequal together with unbelievers." This has caused many in the house of God to be ununited together. Everybody that sits in the pew do not know the Lord.
Oh,
but you must make sure that they come to grips that God is a God of all, not of some.
Yes.
And this is the cause of many conflicts in the house of God. All have not received the new birth.
Come on,
and even those that have received the new birth have not recognized the sanctification.
Yes.
You've been sanctified. Sanctified means that whatever Christ has belongs to you.
Yeah.
God knows he's rich. Yeah, and all you have to do is just accept him as your Savior.
Yeah.
You don't have to do anything. You don't have to put yourself under the law. Give me under grace. But grace does not give you a license to sin.
Yeah.
Grace gives you to make sure that you receive that grace and do the work of the church and the church work. But sometimes we're so busy doing the worst church, we forget the church of the work and the work of the church.
Come on,
we get them all confused.
Amen.
You can come to this building here and do all the work inside here.
Yes.
But if you fail to go out there and do the work of the church, there will be no evangelism going on.
Yes.
They took a survey not so long ago and said, there are no evangelist preachers left in the world today.
Yeah.
They all have stopped evangelizing.
Yeah.
Why? Because they're all depressed.
Yeah.
Also read why pastors now are turning to alcohol to get relief.
Yeah.
The devil's a liar, the truth man in it.
Yeah.
If you know Jesus,
yeah,
he'll give you peace in the midst of the storm.
Yeah.
I tried alcohol, it didn't give me peace.
Amen.
I don't know where they're coming from, but too many have went and have not been sent.
Yes.
That's what's wrong with the world. I'm meddling today, but the world is strong as the church is strong. And that's why we all in need of being pure evangelized.
Yeah, that's right.
Everyone in the house of God is not saved. There are some I would hate to be yoked with.
Amen.
And coming up the rapture. This is a matter of speaking. Because I know you're going to take some and leave some.
Amen.
But that if I'm yoked with somebody, I'm quite sure he has a key to the handcuffs.
Amen.
What do you say, Brother Preacher?
Amen.
We must make sure that we do not be in fellowship with infidels.
Lord, have mercy.
This is why the church is indeed of this evangelism. Salvation must be a part of our itinerary in the house of God. But not only that, we must also be sanctified. I can't say too much. Many people do not understand what sanctification is all about. You can be saved, still on your way to heaven, raising hell. Because you're not receiving the union that God has already given you. Might be sick and have pain, but remember God said with your strength, you're already healed.
Right, right.
The devil gonna make you feel the pain. That's his job.
Yes.
Yeah.
But you need to walk around and say, you remember James Brown? Because I feel good.
Hallelujah.
And I guarantee if you walk around feeling good, you will not feel bad.
Yeah.
Stop speaking your own curse out of your own mouth.
Hallelujah.
I'm trying to help somebody here now.
Hallelujah.
Because God will help you.
Yes.
If you stand on your own faith. Salvation and sanctification is all one cord. Just because you're saved does not mean you're not sanctified, but you got to receive it. I'm trying to help somebody here now, because the churches today are always complaining about something. But if you're sanctified, that means you've been set apart, washed in the blood of the Lamb. You don't worry about if it's hot or cold. You don't worry about the rogue and blue or brown. The preacher's not preaching like you can go over here, or it sounds too loud or not so. You didn't come to pray, you come to praise God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
And stop roaching preacher when you go back home.
Yeah.
High respect for your family to come to the house of God, you were talking down the preacher.
Yeah. Right.
I'm helping somebody here now.
Yeah.
Anything you can't say good about him, keep your mouth shut.
Yeah.
And God is going to bless you.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. The house of God, not participating in the worship of idols. Anything that you put before God is your idol.
Yeah.
Some of us use a husband as an idol.
Yeah.
Wives as an idol. Children as an idol.
Yeah.
Home as an idol. Job as an idol. Hear me now. If you put anything over God, that becomes your idol.
Yeah.
That's why you have to use that sanctification. Sanctify Sundays,
yeah.
Sanctify Wednesdays, sanctify those days that God will make a way for you to be there.
Yeah.
You just looking for an excuse not to be there.
Amen.
I don't feel good. I got to do this. The only thing you have to do is please God.
Hallelujah.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Yeah.
And all these other things that fall in line.
Yeah.
But the devil always make you find some way to keep from coming to the house of God.
Hallelujah.
I told my wife, if I can't get here, drag me here. Nothing's going to keep me out of the house of God. The word of God said, do not touch unclean things. Anything that the church is not in God's plan is unclean.
Yeah.
Yeah, let the world of things go, let go, and let God. Yeah, the world is dark, but Jesus is light. I hope you hear me today.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah, these are areas where the true Christian cannot compromise. This is what's wrong with us today. We compromising too much. People say if you have something to bring the young people in, they'll come. Yeah, maybe one thing we keep them, that's the word of God.
Yeah,
we can have a picnic every Sunday, they'll run the churches over.
Yeah.
Still they're gonna burn the gates of hell wide open.
Yeah.
Church is not a place for fun. It can be used for that, but the church is for salvation and sanctification. That you come to church to praise God and to keep your soul out of the burning hell. We cannot compromise that the Holy Scriptures are not inspired of God. No man could put in this Bible in him everything in this Bible. Rape is in this Bible. Killing is in this Bible. Homosexuality is in this Bible. Hey, fornication. Name it. All sin is in this Bible. God put it there to guide you and I. That's why you cannot compromise the Holy Scripture. 2 Timothy 3:16 says, all Scripture is given by inspiration of God. And is what profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for the instruction of righteousness. If you want to live right, read and study the Word of God. Somebody says, a lamp unto your feet and a light to your pathway. Help me, Holy Ghost. You will walk by faith and not by sight. If there's no faith, there's no produce. If there's no produce, there's no fruit. Without the fruit of the Spirit, we are nothing. We are walking as the empty sepulchre, full of dry bones. Somebody say, can these bones live? I'm so glad we can by the power of the Holy Spirit. We talk about compromise. We cannot compromise that Jesus Christ is God in the flesh. Now, if you have trouble believing that Jesus Christ is God, you got a problem in your life. The Word said, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All of these denominations that they're telling Jesus is just a prophet. He just this and that, but he is God all by himself. That's why you need to call on that name. You can't compromise the born of the Virgin Mary. John 1:14 said, and the Word of the city were made flesh and dwelt among us. And we believe his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Jesus came, yes he did. He came as on his own, no one seen him not. He's a Jew. He came to the Jewish nation. There's a Haman there. And all of the Jewish organization turned their back on him because he could not believe he could be the Son of God. And we have a lot of Orthodox Jews today don't accept him as God's Son. So if you can't accept him as his Son, you sure can't accept him as being God. Are you following me? But Jesus came to set the captives free. Too many of us, wolves in sheep clothing. Have not separated himself from the entire world. I made a statement before they took a survey. Many pastors now turn to alcohol in order to solve their problem. But something wrong when Jesus is not in your life. That's why you got to come out of the world. And they got all kind of books out there. And a lot of the books should be burned because they're putting man's own account of what God's plan should be. You can't change God's plan. If God's plan said a man and a woman is it, that's it. I don't care whether you like it or not. Same-sex marriage is a damnation against God. I don't see how a rusty man can look at another rusty man anyway. Somebody better help me, Holy Ghost. Right now is the day the world we live in. Because they tell us now if we preach the gospel, we call us haters. But I have to say what the Word of God says. I don't know what some of these preachers are reading, but the Word of God says, I didn't say it. Also say if you have intercourse with animals, it's a damnation, you're going to hell. Somehow help me, Holy Ghost. We cannot compromise though. We cannot compromise the Holy Spirit is at work in the world today. We got some denomination now say the Holy Spirit was for yesterday. That's a lie, the truth ain't in it. Without the Holy Ghost, there's no conviction. Without no conviction, there's no salvation. Where there's no salvation, there's no sanctification. Where there's none of this, there's no justification. We've been justified. By the work of the Holy Spirit. John 16:7-8, you need to read it sometime. I wish I had time. because to read more of the scripture, but you had some time had to read for yourself. I don't know. Some of us come to church, want the pastor to read the word, explain the word, act the word, live the word. What are you going to do? I'm mailing now. The Bible is there for you to read. I can tell you one thing. You remember Jim Jones? He got rid of the Bible. They're following him. They're all burning in hell right now. Don't take the preacher for his word. Read it for yourself. That's why he said you got to be separated. Come out from among them.
Yeah.
And God is going to bless you.
Yeah.
Are you following me? Because something about that, you need to take time to read God's word.
Yeah.
And that the Holy Spirit will, like a light bulb, without caring.
Amen.
No glory, no light, and no power.
Come on,
oh, we need power.
Yeah.
Holy Ghost power.
Yeah.
Last but not least, there is a reason that God wants his people to be separated.
Yeah, yeah.
Not only come out from among them, but sometimes we got to separate ourselves.
Yeah.
Sometimes we separate them for the purpose of resting.
Yeah.
Too many of us are burnt out.
Yeah.
We need to take time to rest every now and then.
Yeah.
Sometimes you separate them for the purpose of just resting. If you read Mark 16:31-35, he said, and he said unto them, come ye yourselves apart into the desert place and rest a while, for there will be many coming and going, and they have no leisure so much as to even eat. In other words, they're parted for rest. That's why if you're leaving the church, take a few times off to rest yourself.
Amen.
I was going in, the Lord knocked me down by himself. Yeah, made me sick for about a week there. If you got a list of it, I'll make you sick. But God knows the devil had no power. Yeah, because the next week I was back rested. But you need to, he separates you. He gives you sense. Come out from among the world. Stop these worldly things. Go in your closet and pray a little while. You must take time to rest and to avoid burnout. Are you following me?
Yeah.
I had much more to say, but at times, Jesus also took them apart so that he could what? Answer questions in their minds. Because we're reading Matthew 26:17-19, they were trying to say, we are the day we don't hear what he is saying. He told them, the third day he's going to rise again.
Yes.
They weren't paying any attention to him because Jesus took the disciples up and told them, say, I'm going to depart from you.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm here with you now, but come a time I won't be with you.
Yes.
I'm going to be killed. But he told them the third day he was going to rise.
Yes.
And here were the 12 disciples. He told that all over again.
Yes.
But when he died, they wouldn't hold themselves in the room.
Yes.
Try to lock themselves from the outside world. Well, we are no different today. We talk about we trust God, we believe in God. Still, we go home, we turn to the lights. We got bars up to our windows.
Yeah.
Two locks on one door.
Yeah.
And locks keep the honest person out. And when somebody hear me today, if somebody want to get to you, he'll get to you one way or the other.
Yeah.
The only text you got to be covered with the righteousness of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
There's something about that righteousness protect you from that. I know what I'm talking about. Oh, they called me one day when I was working with a gun in front of me and a gun in my head. Yeah, but I'm still here. They took my money, but I prayed for them because I knew I was dressed in his righteousness. My wife got home and said, did you lose your pocketbook? I said, no, I was robbed. She said, well, your pocketbook and your money is in the front door screen here. Through the righteousness of God, they couldn't even keep my money. They brought it back to me like they took it. When they look at you, they don't see you. Oh, so they see God, which is in you.
Yeah.
I'm trying to help somebody here now.
Yeah.
I had trouble with pastor standing behind the pulpit. I trust in the Lord with a 45 in his pocket.
Yeah.
What kind of trust is that?
Yeah.
I see all these preachers riding around with 4 or 5 guards walk behind them. What are you afraid of?
Yeah. That's
God's your protection. He'll protect you through all harm and danger. And don't use that excuse for God give you a mind. You ain't got no mind. You got God's mind. Yeah, I knocked that down right quick. Yeah, he said, don't be a fool. Well, you say you trust in God, you're not a fool if you're trusting. I'm not afraid to go anywhere and do anything. As far as I'm concerned, you can leave the lock off the door. I'm not afraid of them. Stop it, all they can do is take this old body. They can't take your soul. The best thing that happened to you is being glory with God. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. What are you talking about? Sometimes he separates you, and when he does it for a reason. But we talk about compromising. So stop compromising the Holy Ghost. Because his guidance and power, you need to accomplish his work. Yeah, we mess up things in the house of God trying to use our own strength. Yeah, we need to make sure that God's plan is God's plan. I heard him in the Sunday school this morning. If God give you something to do, you already know how to do it. That's not God's plan. God is going to assign you to a task that you have no idea how it's going to work out. That's why you got to put your trust in God. If God said it, stand up and do it. And God will make a way out of no way. Well, I wish I had time to explain. The church is too busy counting dollars instead of trusting God. Yeah. God didn't pay this church off twice by trusting money. God will make a way out of no way. I'm trying to help somebody here now. Walk. The sign said we walk by faith and not by sight. So walk by faith. Live by faith. Act by faith. Yeah, but come out from among them. He separated some, to show himself to them in that glorious way. You remember the story on the Tribulation Mountain? He carried Peter, James, and John with him up into the mountain. And to tell him you got there, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, talking about the glory of God. Moses represented the law. Jesus was the grace. Elijah was power. You had law, grace, and power on that mountain. Peter said, let us build some tabernacles here so you can live in it. Jesus said, no. Oh, that's not why we're here. He told them, he tell them this is a vision. And tell this to no man until I be risen again. In other words, he told them, keep it to themselves because they're not going to believe it. I wish they had more time. In a day when so many people are willing to compromise principles in order to be a part of a crowd. May the truth child of God remember the necessity of being a separate people. I realize when you go to school, you're not in a certain crowd, you got to be willing. Stand on your own 2 feet. Tell me you're serving the living God. And with God is free, who would be against you? I don't know about you, but I love to serve the living God. God, I always cry, God, let it rain. Let it rain in my heart. And separate me from this world. Let it rain love in my heart. I want to rain peace in my heart. Rain joy in my heart. Yeah, rain humility in my heart. Rain unity in my heart. Rain comfort in my heart. Rain compassion in my heart. Let it rain. I said, let it rain. Let it rain Jesus in my heart. All I need is just a little more Jesus. I found out a long time ago. Jesus, the rose of Sharon, lily of the valley, bright and morning star. Jesus, rock in a barren land, wheel in the middle of the wheel. Bread when I'm hungry, water when I'm thirsty, joy when I'm sad. In the all right church, he's my regulator. Yeah, he's my heart fixer. Jesus, Jesus. All about Jesus. I don't know about you, but in the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. Sickness have to heal. Sadness will turn into joy. We came die so you and I could live. Is it all right, church? I get happy when I talk about the Lord. I say I get happy because I was seeking death and sin. For from that people sure, there were demons staying within, seeking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard not this man cry. From the water lifted me, now save me. Is he all right, church? Is he all right? I'm on the way to glory. If you don't believe I've been redeemed, follow me down to the Jordan Stream. Why? Because the Lord is my life, my salvation. Whom shall I pray? He's your shepherd. Is he all right, church? Yes, he died, but he's not dead. He lives in you
made the lame walk, the dumb talk, and the blind could see. Is he all right, church? Is he able? Is he able? I know it, God. Took him down from the grave. Stayed there all day Friday, all Friday night, all day Saturday, all Sunday, but early, early, in the Sunday morning. Be ye separate.
Amen.
You are a peculiar person.
Yes.
Holy nation.
Yes.
We are somebody.
Amen.
In Christ. Stop walking around complaining. Keep a smile on your face.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Yes. Remember that. You are the temple of the living God.
Yes.
God is in you.
Amen.
I'm going to say it again. This church, not the temple of God.
Amen.
You are the temple of God.
Amen.
So God will not live in you if you are not fit to be lived in.
Amen.
All because of what his son did for you when he died. Take it and run with it.
Yes.
Enjoy life.
Yes.
You only come this way one time.
That's right.
May we stand to our feet, please.
That's right.
Come on, take a strong stand up here. It's all right. You got it. The doors of the church are now open. Remember, he said, come unto me, all you labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. So all you do, learn of him, he'll give you rest. As the cross says, come give me your hand, you got to give your heart to God. Everyone here this morning, come give yourself to God.
God bless you.
Yes, we are great to have Sister Harris. She's not a stranger here. She's been here before, and she just, she didn't find him, he found her. The word says if you find a woman, you find a good thing. So that is Reverend Harris's wife. I had the opportunity to be a part of that, and God has blessed her. And thank you, Sister Harris. We do have a new membership class. Not that you need it, but just to let you know how we operate here at Mount Zion. Then we'll be in touch with you. Go to the new membership class. But when you first stuck your head in the door, you became one of God's children, because you just came from another church here. So we have no power to do one way than the happy. But this young lady has papers. I've checked them. She's a strong deaconess in the church she came from. So in Christ's show should be accessed to here at Mount Zion. What's his name?
Jesus!
You may have a seat, Sister Harris, right now. We thank God for your presence. Reverend Harris got somebody to keep him straight now.
Amen.
The only thing I want to say now, be careful. This is 4th of July. Be careful how you use the firecrackers, whatever you call them. If you're going to shoot firecrackers, make sure you have a big bucket of water somewhere else.
Amen.
And if you throw one of those bombs down, don't go off. Don't go try to pick it up. Just pour the water on it and let it lay there and light you another, because too many fingers have been blown off. And be careful with the sparklers, because a lot of clothing will catch fire quickly. Why are you saying this? Because every 4th of July, many lives are lost, limbs are lost because of carelessness. Have a good time, but do it in the name of the Lord. Can you say amen to that? So if you're truly going to use a firecracker, make sure you be there to guide them and do it in the right way. Don't just give them a bunch of firecrackers and turn them loose. Because he's liable to burn your house down.
Amen.
Give us a going home business, that brother. Have him sing through one time. Supper is kept indeed, and whatsoever we share with another's need. May the grace of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the love of God, communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with us all evermore. And all the saints present sing.